To make a short story long, I somehow ended up on the hunt for the world's lightest tactile switch. I might have been trying to go pro in TypeRacer, who knows. Anyways, a quick search for a light tactile switch brings up these results. 58 grams and 63 grams. Are you kidding me? I'm getting RSI just thinking about these. The infamous Trey Browns are between 45 and 55 grams, depending on who you ask. So it looks like 45 grams is the number to beat here. Expanding our search brings up the Carol Hawkel Violets with 35 grams of force, which sound perfect in theory, except for one thing. They sound terrible in person. I'm glad I bought a switch tester before shelling out $65 for a pack of 90 of these, because man was I disappointed. They're basically on the same level of scratchiness as cherries. You can probably even hear the scratch if you listen close enough. I suppose a lot of my problems could be solved with lube, but I'm not ready to sell my soul to this mechanical keyboard hobby just yet. Editor's note, I just bought my first pack of lube, so yeah, we're going down this rabbit hole actually. I have one more trick left. Gatoron Browns. Ah yes, the more popular younger brother of the Cherry Browns. Commonly recommended as a smoother version of cherries, perhaps these could solve my problem. To no one's surprise, they're quite nice actually. However, practically speaking, they're pretty much the same white as the Cherry Browns. But remember that Reddit thread about the Hawkel Violets? Spring swapping, huh? Well, at least it's not lubing. Now we just have to get below 45 grams. A quick search on AliExpress brings us these. A 10 gram difference doesn't sound like much, but it's the lowest number they got. I remember reading that if a spring is too light, it won't have enough force to reset the switch, so hopefully that doesn't happen here. I originally wanted to film this entire spring swapping section at once and make it look cool with the time lapse and everything, but I got bored during a work meeting and just went at it. To make matters worse, I didn't have a switch opener. I had ordered one with the springs, but it still hasn't arrived a month later. Spring swapping is relatively straightforward. The only problem is telling the difference between the old and new spring if you accidentally drop one. If you look closely between the two, you can tell that one has the coils closer together. Also, remember when I said that the spring might not be able to reset? Luckily, we're mostly fine with this except for the spacebar. It would occasionally get stuck, so I kept it on the original spring. After that's all said and done, here are the results. There's honestly not much difference in terms of sound, but here's a before and after in case you're curious. Also, here are spring swap Cherry Browns if that's your thing. The biggest takeaway here is definitely the feel. I can't really convey lightness through a video, but here are my TypeRacer results with an improvement of about 10 words per minute. Honestly, I definitely think this mod is worth it if you're looking for lighter switches. My fingers are a lot less tired after a day of typing, and a pack of 110 springs only costs about $7. My next step is looking into lubing, as I want to make not only the lightest tactile switch, but also the smoothest one. I'll be lubing both the Cherry and Gatoron Browns, so make sure you subscribe for when that comes out. But that's all for this one, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.